be afraid. I am here to take you to a good life. A life that you were born to. I beg you, Uncle, love her as I would were I here, and ensure that she is in receipt of all that is due to her as a child of mine.
Do you have in mind my position?
That is simply impossible.
What is right can never be impossible.
What has she been named?
Dido Belle Lindsay.
She takes your name.
I am not ashamed.
Well, I was at university in Scotland, and I went to visit Scone Palace. And in Scotland, I was very often, I didn't see that many other black people. So imagine walking into one of the bedrooms of this stately home and seeing this black woman staring directly out at me from the painting. I was so struck by her grace, her beauty, the directness, I think, of the gaze. And it made me say, this is a story I would love to tell. I wasn't a writer in those days, but I remembered her, and I came back to the story years later.
Elizabeth was in much need of a companion.
And that is what we shall say when questions are asked.
We shall be receiving visitors for dinner.
Why do you not dine with your family ever?
Because that is not correct.
May I present the second of my two nieces, Miss Dido Lindsay?
I find her repulsive.
Papa, how may I be too high in rank to dine with the servants and too low to dine with my family?
Though I understand she is kept under interesting rules, she raises questions.
It started from a place of Damien sending me the painting. Damien had been trying to get a film like this off the ground, about Dido's history, off the ground for a long time. He had originally started trying to get a project off with the writer who's credited on the movie. But by the time he had came to me, he'd sort of moved on and was very much looking for somebody who could more or less start again from scratch and try and create a vision and choose the right story to tell that would attract financing and that would attract a cast. And so for me, I had to start with the themes. What were the themes of the story that I wanted to tell, and looking at race and politics and history, and then gender, making the parallels between gender and race, the idea of ownership, for instance. Slaves were owned and women were owned back then. That's why we took our husband's last name. That's where it originated from. So looking at all of those themes and looking at how the kind of story that I wanted to tell, and through which lens I wanted to tell. I knew I wanted something to be witty. I wanted something, a movie that I could make that would make you laugh as well as make you cry. And so for me, by the time I came on board, it was just Damien Jones and myself. And it was about weaving together all of the themes of the story that I wanted to tell. And sometimes he would say to me, Amma, it's entirely too much. And I would say, I promise you, we can do this. I can do it. Just give me a chance. And creating a balance. But also it was about making a film that I would like to go and see. I always think of myself in many ways, rather than as a filmmaker, as an audience member, and saying, well, would I want to sit for 1 hour, 45 minutes and watch this movie? And luckily with Belle, I can say yes.
Would you do me the honour of taking some air with me?
Don't you care what people will say?
What should anyone say?
I have no idea. Should be so black.
One does not make a wife of the rare and exotic.
Does she still have a tongue?
I have a tongue.
Though yours explains well enough why I may not marry your son. My greatest misfortune would be to marry into a family who would carry me as their shame.
There's three mirror scenes, in fact, in the film. You know, the first one being where Dido is kind of clawing at her face in a kind of self-harming moment of despair. And then the second one really is the mirror scene. And that's where she's learning to become a little bit more comfortable with her appearance and you know, how she is. And I think the third one is where she's sort of taking off the engagement ring and you know, about to sort of put Lady Ashford in her place. And for me, I think, you know, the idea of identity and the idea of how you look and all of those things is very contemporary, but I think essentially the message is that shouldn't be what defines you. It's an expression of who you are, for sure, but it shouldn't be, you know, what's inside is what's important. And I think that's where Dido, you know, grows, is that she becomes comfortable with who she is inside and out.